Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
And now back to regularly scheduled program. Every year, this Twitter user named HHN Nightmares releases a speculation map with different houses with symbols that equate to the different themes of the house. So I'm going to be giving my thoughts on what I think these symbols mean. And first off, in Soundstage 23B, we have a Cadillac logo, which it was pretty unanimously thought out to be the Ghostbusters. The Ghostbusters house first appeared in 2019 and was a massive hit. Halloween Horror Nights 2019 as a whole was incredible. I mean, I'm very excited for Ghostbusters to return. There's a new movie coming out, I believe, in May 22nd, maybe? Somewhere around there, that, you know, this could do good marketing for. Now, Soundstage 24B is the one that got me a little confused, but the lollipop, I was looking up different horror films that had lollipops in them, and I came across Trick or Treat. A great movie, and you know, there's a little boy with the lollipop in his mouth. So I think that makes the most sense. Sprung Tent 4, this one was pretty obvious to me as well. I thought immediately Nightmare on Elm Street. A lot of others thought that as well. Being Freddy Krueger, which we haven't seen in a while. I don't think we've seen him since the... I'm not sure which Horror Nights it was, but it was Horror Nights 20-something. Or I might have that wrong as well. Horror Nights 20-something, where him and Jason Voorhees had a Halloween house together, Freddy versus Jason. Now we have Sprung Tent 3, which features a symbol of a speaker crossed out. This obviously equates to A Quiet Place. A Quiet Place, there's two movies, another one on the way this summer, so this again will be great marketing. Now, Sprung Tent 1 also stumped me. A lot of people were saying because of the mythology, Poseidon's Fury. I don't think that makes sense, at least for that one. But I think that there is a horror movie, or not really a horror movie, more of a fantasy movie, called Immortals. Yeah, Immortals, which features a scary-looking Minotaur. There also is an actual horror movie with a Minotaur, with Tom Hardy. Next up, we're going to be talking about a potential video game house. And I'm wearing the Last of Us shirt from last year. So Universal obviously is not against doing video games at this event at all. Especially, I think they definitely did it last year because of the success of not only the video game, but the HBO Max series. So Fast and Furious Supercharges Q doesn't have... It's under unknown IP. I think this very well could be Five Nights at Freddy's. I'm not a big gamer, per se. I mean, for Five Nights at Freddy's was a pretty well-received movie among fans. I mean, not critics, per se, but who cares what the critics say? I also, this is just wishful thinking, but I don't know. I don't even think it's big enough of a space, but Beetlejuice 2 is coming out in September. So I was thinking, oh, maybe marketing-wise, do Beetlejuice? But I don't think that's going to work out. If anything, it would be next year. Now, Soundstage 22 also stumped me a little bit, but I have broken it down to Universal Monsters. Something Universal Monsters. I mean, that's what makes the most sense currently. If not that, those masks do look like the ones that the guys wear in the Skull Island Reign of Kong ride. You know, maybe a King Kong haunted house. But that's also just wishful thinking. So I think that, you know, could be a bit on the nose, but last year it was Universal Monsters Unmasked, and now there's a mask. So maybe now they're Universal Monsters Remasked. Of course, that's a joke. I'm not being serious, but something to do with Universal Monsters is probably the most ideal, especially considering Epic Universe next year will be opening a Universal Monsters land called Dark Universe. So this very well could build the lore per se of that land. So also on the map, you could see the Death Eaters will probably be returning a fire symbol, which I think equates to the Halloween Nightmare Fuel Show, which, you know, of course, features fire as the biggest aspect. And also, another one that kind of stumped me was Soundstage 24A. Of course, I didn't go to Halloween Horror Nights last year. I got this shirt in the presale. I haven't been to Halloween Horror Nights in a couple years because, you know, it just doesn't work out with school and everything. But apparently there was a comic book theme to Halloween Horror Nights. And the tribute store, at least, was themed to a comic book. And on the comic book, on the pages and the covers, there were this exact skull system, skull logo, as seen in the speculation for that soundstage. This could be expanding the story of what is simply a store, but, you know, with Universal, a store could be, you know, the most incredible thing of all time and have all this lore behind it. Now, there is a castle logo next to the lagoon area. So this is rumored to be a new show based on, who knows, but, you know, probably just the different themes of the houses this year. I don't know what the castle has to do with it. You know, I think that was just, it probably does allude to something, but right now, I can't think of anything. Now, Soundstage 23A, last but not least, features a house that was shown in Hollywood last year, at least I think, being monstrous. I didn't do it, but I'm excited. I looked at some videos. I think it seems really cool. If not that, I think that Creature of the Black Lagoon, being, you know, it's a show's Latin America, so I think that those two make the most sense. So these were all of my predictions for the Halloween Horror Nights 33 speculation sheet. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.